a rocket-fueled launch. Requires air traffic control. Monitoring the precise patterns which guide plain old out of this world soaring and scoring. Expect some terrificness. So that sign should stay lit the entire journey. With the ground crew always waiting for safe landing, to then drive the runway. Documenting such a sports story, powerful enough for a 30 on 30 episode.
Aiden, you did not take your steps, Aiden. You just went directly outside.
This is your pilot speaking. First down and 10. You can put this game away against Cardinal Gibbons. Your offense has averaged 10 yards play all year.
Yeah.
What went wrong?
Yeah, you know, it's full onus is on me, right? I mean, I don't feel like I ever was able to get us in a groove that whole night. So that's 100% on the play caller, and that's me. I wear that hat. So, you know, again, it's probably that we didn't execute, right? We just didn't execute, whatever it might have been. A little thing here, a bad step here, a misstep here. Yeah, it is what it is. The kids have looked at the film. You know, we obviously learned from it. And we just move on now. Move on.
Do you change any of those full plays?
Yeah. So I would change third down. Yeah, third down, I've gone back in my head a couple times. We had a couple discussions on the headsets. You know, it was a timeout right before we went back out there. And we had discussions on the headset, this or that, or this or that, and I went away from my gut, and if I had a chance, I'd go back to it. I'm calling that fourth down play every day, all day. Just that's our bread and butter. That's our bread and butter play, running behind our best side, with our best running back in the state. And but third down, I would probably change what I did on third down. I've said it a bunch of times to our staff, and to my wife a bunch too. But you know, a lot of things happened that night that just were outside of what we see. I mean, our top guy fumbles and he never fumbles. Our kicker slips and he never slips. You know, I mean, the most accurate kicker in the state. Just little things. We missed a block here that we don't ever miss. We didn't pick up a stunt here that we normally pick up. We didn't make a read here where, like, we don't. Crazy things happen. And again, listen, all the credit in the world to Gibbons, man. I mean, they got a great staff over there. We got nothing but respect for those guys. We can't wait to see them over in week four.
That's the best thing about it is you know you get to see them.
Absolutely, yeah. Look forward to it.
This takes away nothing from your offense, with one of the best the state's ever seen. Y'all produce four All-State guys. I mean, come on, it's tremendous. But an offense has to evolve.
No doubt.
How is this one evolved?
Yeah, so it's been a fun spring because we don't have to install anything, right? So we have everything that we want to run in. It's just making those fine little tweaks, those fine little adjustments that nobody will know the difference really until we get out there on the field, and they'll be like, oh, okay, that is different. And it'll be a little harder to prepare for us because, yeah, I mean, listen, there's 14 game films out there on our offense. Everybody's going to know what we do. Everybody knows our guys. We've just been fine-tuning stuff, adding little things here and there, but nothing. I mean, listen, it's not going to be anything crazy. You kind of go with what got you there, what works, and with the guys we got. So I've always been a big guy. Make sure the backup guy has a lot of reps, just in case. You never know what's going to happen. It's the same thing with Mason. He's just now it's his second year in the system, so he should feel more comfortable in it. He's just getting the reps in because, you know, he deserves the reps, right? He's going to be a senior too. Let him have the reps out here, and then once we get to fall camp, we'll kind of see how things kind of play out.
You've got a great toy box to work with,
yeah.
But your intensity's still there now.
Yeah.
Why are we walking? Walk again and we run.
Yeah. How do you keep them guys motivated?
We didn't win the ship. We didn't play the second week of December. I mean, that if that wasn't motivation enough for these guys, then I'm not sure why we're out here. These guys had all the numbers in the world. We did really well offensively. I thought we played really great defensively too. But, you know, these guys are reaping those benefits. I mean, all of our guys are getting all these offers and all that fun stuff, which is awesome. That's why we do it as coaches, right? For those kids to go off and better themselves at the next level. But these guys know that we fell 2 weeks short. 2 weeks short of the ultimate goal, and that's what's been motivating them, right? And so me personally, yeah, I mean, again, it's not year one like last year where we were installing everything. This is year two, so the expectations are a whole lot higher from our staff. We don't want to see these mistakes. That's motivation. The number one thing that we got to, and I don't really want to say fix or do anything like that, because I really think our guys did a really good job, is right. It's what Rack kind of calls it, says everything. It says for us every day is, just got to finish a job, man. We got to finish a job. We didn't. We got a little complacent, I want to say, maybe. We were kind of relaxed a little bit. You know, we're the number one seed. Everybody's got to come through Rolesville. Listen, we played hard. We fought hard. And just the chips didn't fall our way that way. But so, I mean, this year, we just got to finish. And that's the goal, right? We always want to do a little bit better. Again, I think these guys have just really worked hard in the offseason. They've all done the stuff that we've done in the building. They've done all the spring work out here. They've done – a lot of these guys have done the extra work outside of our eyes, which just shows us as coaches that they really want this. And since they really want it, it's gonna make it a little easier for us to elevate what we did last year. It ain't. Now listen, we know it ain't gonna be easy, but the first 4 weeks of the season are murderer's row, right? So we look forward to all that opportunities. And really, if it was up to me, we'd go strap it up and go to Butler now, but we gotta wait a little bit.
Given the wheels and wings' superior status, ride or fly should be anything but Boeing.
Believe it or not, I've called a bad play. It's hard to believe, right, Brady? I've called a bad play.
Let's lock in. Be aggressive with the ball in the air. Be physical.
Good, Corey. Thank you. Be aggressive. There we go, Chase. That's where you play it. Up high. You and AJ, y'all got to play up high.
Assurance in protection and relocation looms large via AZA mid-jet propulsion.
Step back and out, cross over, get around the board, fine for the backer, okay?
Yeah.
Set! Go!
Get around that board.
The dig is more like I'm going this way, I take a cut at 45 and then I cut down a lot.
And we gotta communicate, alright? Be annoying, alright? Talk, alright? Be annoying to, I don't care if they know what's going on. You know what I'm saying? Who I'm looking at? Talk, alright? I don't care if they know what you play is. Oh, bro. All right, because in the game it's gonna translate.
When assembling his let's goes from front building blocks,
receivers, Saints comes to you, you're blocking. Just like rain.
Go better block like a man.
Put your head in the back. Set! Go! Get your down blocks on.
He has a family.
Outside, buried in the shoulder. Okay?
Hold on, coach.
Get up. Oh, yeah. Let me not keep going.
Now get that some.
Up towards the fence.
Let's go. Set. Up.
I ain't gonna do it.
Two outstanding pieces.
Drop off.
Like glue glove, Jadon offered. To that fully back pack. What a well-equipped compliment will sit alongside a walloping defense.
Good, good, good. Middle, middle, middle. Logan, don't touch him. Get a deeper pull.
Hence my compliments to the chief.
start celebrating and I have to teach you how to celebrate, let me know. I can coach that up. Anytime we do something great, we should be fired up on the sideline. Offense, defense, whatever. Obviously, we're going against each other, so anytime we do something great offensively, you guys should be hollering.
Certainly fitting, this phase ends with a yell of a play, which flipped at least one lid. This astound wave of talent. I'm Don Fuller, Eastwake Television.